most people meet me, I come off hard, abrasive, not too much in between. Things seem to be black and white. The reality of it is that I'm very, very soft. I think I got a lot of love to give. There's something about me that I just don't give up no matter what it is. I might not come out on top, but I always keep going and going. It's probably what I'm most proudest about.
As crazy as it sounds, you know how they talk about kids like that have autism? They do certain things and it soothes them. I get the same effect when I do landscaping. Mostly when I weed whack, as crazy as that sounds, because it's loud and there's shit hitting me in the face and all this other stuff, but there's something about it that brings me peace. Honestly, that's really it.
These two girls I know that live over in Garwood. They're sisters. One lives downstairs, one lives upstairs. And their father died not too long ago. We left them a two-family house. Neither of them work. One is diagnosed hardcore bipolar. The one that lives upstairs, she's got cancer. They don't have the money. They got this big yard. It needed a lot of work, the outside, the inside. So I spend a lot of time over there. You name it, I did it over there, and there's more to do. I don't charge them. I really don't. How are you going to charge somebody like that? I can't do that. I do that because who else is going to do it? I grew up in a couple different places. In Roselle, New Jersey, and the other part was in Jersey City, Bayonne, Hudson County area. Both of my parents were working, so either I'd go to one place, I'd go to the other. I always felt something like full of fear and anxiety, and that all came from the household that I grew up in. The household was crazy. My father was a drug addict for many, many years. Where I'd never be like him, but I turned out to be exactly like him, and worse in a lot of ways. Yeah, physical abuse would be like, yeah, like getting smacked and shit. The mental abuse or the verbal abuse would be the comments that come out of somebody's mouth. High school was all right. It was more grammar school, like 7th, 8th grade. Kids just are cruel. They just call you names and stuff like that. When people do that to you, you know, you feel like alone. There's one kid that does it, and then another kid jumps on the bandwagon because he wants to feel cool or impress the other kid. Then see two or three, four, five, six people like that, you know, it's enough to make your day miserable at school. So it was difficult for me to go to school a lot of times. The most hardest time of my life was the addiction, the cocaine. Anything you put in front of me, I did. The devil is still calling. It calls loud. And that, I would have to say, for me, the fact that I haven't gone back there is God. There's no doubt about it. I believe that I got so hooked up onto the drugs. It's the mental illness. I mean, the ADHD and the depression or I don't necessarily want to say bipolar because I was never diagnosed with that, but I do believe that I got certain, you know, traits of it. If they would have caught this when I was growing up, it would have been a major difference because I would have understood what the hell was going on in school. My father wouldn't have thought that I was lazy versus not understanding. The staff of the school would have saw what was going on. They could have got me the proper help. I would have found schoolwork more interesting. I would have read. I never read a book. Not one book. Not one book did I ever read from cover to cover from up until the age of like 33 years old. So book reports, all that stuff, especially like history and stuff with dates and stuff. It wasn't that I wasn't interested. I just didn't know what the hell was going on. I just cheated off of whoever I could cheat off of. Slipped through the cracks, got C's, and here I am, all these years later. I definitely believe it could have led to college, it could have led to me choosing a career or something that, you know, that I really, really would enjoy. Now my choices are limited at my age, you know what I mean? They're limited, so, you know, I kind of sometimes have to take what I can get. You know, that doesn't always make life so great.